Romney becomes the next president of the United States in November. San Diego could be the next home to the Western White House, and that could have a big impact on the surrounding community. In a special report tonight, KUSI's Tom Jordan looks at how a Romney presidency could bring huge and sometimes unwanted attention to one quiet La Jolla street.
This small street in the heart of San Diego's crown jewel, La Jolla, holds what may become one of the most powerful homes on the West Coast. At Dunmere Drive sits his 3,009-square-foot home overlooking the Pacific, the home of presidential candidate Mitt Romney and potentially the future Western White House.
Doesn't thrill me no end.
Yeah.
I'm kind of anti-political.
It's exciting. I mean, it's really neat.
Residents of this quaint and exclusive portion of Western San Diego County can sense the excitement. Marisa Valbona is one of them. She is fully aware that the GOP presidential contender returns often to his La Jolla oceanfront home. Holiday weekends see the Romneys spending family time on the beach, strolling through the village, and bringing with them the glaring spotlight of presidential politics and all that comes with it.
I really think the neatest thing is what it's going to be doing to the economy, what it's going to be doing to all of these small businesses, these boutiques. When you look at what George W. Bush did for Crawford, it made that economy thrive.
Inside a Western White House, are the inner workings much like the White House in D.C.?
Absolutely, for the simple reason that in the modern presidency, starting with the 20th century, it's 24/7 as far as the world crisis, et cetera.
Political consultant John Dadian, no stranger to the role a Western White House has on a local community. He was around when Richard Nixon had his estate in San Clemente, when Ronald Reagan often retreated to his Santa Barbara ranch, and when George W. Bush put Crawford, Texas on the map.
Ronald Reagan actually spent 1/8 of his presidency at either the Western White House or outside the White House. So it depends on the president's personality, but he could be spending quite a bit of time here.
The prospect of having a Western White House on this quiet La Jolla Street is exciting for a lot of people in San Diego. But for those who live on this quiet Dunmere Drive, that kind of attention that a sitting president would bring here doesn't always sit well. And then add to that a massive reconstruction project on this property.
I object to his mansionizing a small, quaint house in an area which is comprised mostly of small, quaint houses.
Romney's home is permitted for renovation and expansion. Plans call for more than doubling the living space from 3,009 square feet to about 8,000 square feet. Then add to that several more thousand square feet for a new basement and a multi-level garage equipped with elevators. Too much for this narrow street with homes sitting so close to each other with people who appreciate their privacy?
The big difference is, especially with Reagan and Bush, they had ranches, so it really didn't impact the neighbors, et cetera. It was kind of secluded, especially Reagan's in Santa Barbara. This isn't a very dense, you know, single family homes, but to residential areas, it will greatly impact the neighbors.
It's a congested area at best because it has narrow streets and not much ingress and egress. And so to have, you know, big black limousines parked all over the street, I would think it would be a big invasion of privacy personally.
This man, who did not want to speak on camera, lives directly across Dunmere Drive from Mitt Romney. His take? Well, he says Mitt Romney is a great neighbor, a friendly man, and respectful of his property rights.
So I walked up to him.
Of course, how much of Mitt Romney's presence will be felt or even noticed depends entirely on the outcome of November's election. As president, La Jolla likely becomes the vacation headquarters for the leader of the free world, with heads of state likely enjoying one of the most picturesque spots in the world. As a private citizen, La Jolla remains a quaint but pricey hometown for another high-profile resident. I'm Tom Jordan, KUSI News.